Acceleration is the kinematics variable that's the most abstract and the most difficult to understand. And so I'm going to spend some time with it. I'm going to do some examples. Most of that is going to be next lecture. Right now, I just want to start with the basics. So average acceleration is defined as delta v over delta t. Now, let me remind you about the delta notation. We've already seen it once, relating displacement to position vectors. This actually works with anything. Delta smiley face is smiley face final minus smiley face initial. In my case, I'm using it for instantaneous velocity. You know it's instantaneous because there's no average subscript. So what this means is the difference between the final instantaneous velocity of a trip and the initial instantaneous velocity of a trip. You might wonder why we don't break delta t up into t final minus t initial. Well, the only reason we do that is because delta t is always positive anyway, because you go forward in time. And so for that reason, we leave it as delta t. There's nothing exciting happening there. And in fact, very shortly, we're just going to not even bother to do that. We're just going to call it t being the time taken. So whether or not we call it delta t or t, it's the time between what we're calling the initial point and the final point. So let's talk about what acceleration really means. Well, acceleration is telling you how the velocity changes with time. So it's basically telling you how the velocity, the instantaneous velocity, changes with time. Another really useful way to think of it is it's the instructions to the velocity, the instantaneous velocity, on how to change with time. And we'll find later that there's good reason to think of the acceleration as kind of giving the instructions. So let's take a look at the units of this. Well, the units, well, the numerator is going to be a difference in velocities, so that's meters per second. And then the denominator is in seconds. So you can literally think of this as the acceleration is how many meters per second velocity should change every second. So how many meters per second should the velocity change by in a second? I like this form at least to start because it's very conceptual. Well, I'll use that at first, but for those of you that may notice, mathematically, these seconds are both in the denominator. So you can also write this as meters per second squared. So this is a compact notation that we'll use once we're comfortable with it. Okay, so that's where I ended the lecture that this is slotting in for. So I'm going to pick up the rest in the next lecture.